I think she'll state the year. She probably knows. Thank you, my favorite. Thank you, Boy Mom. Boy Mom, I need you. I think you ignored a comment of mine where I said I'm gonna leave you once you say to me, Zanele, I'm a candidate of a master's. You ignored that comment. I want to say it here during the people. Good evening. But I met Uzikhona, or I knew Uzikhona from Facebook. There was a year where she posted her home, right? She posted, "Hi, Mabatidi. Hi, darling." She Uzikhona posted her Eastern Cape home as well as her Cape Town home. So she built her mom a home in the Eastern Cape, and also built her home in Cape Town. So like if Emilia had a home in Cape Town, and obviously as ma abantu we also have a home. And in Lolis and Amchanja but yeah, so Uzikhona posted a post that I think in a she said that I've built these two homes in a very short period of time. I think it was 1 year. I think she's gonna touch on that. I think it was 1 year. And the first thing that came to my mind was like, this is not an ordinary nurse. Like a nurse that is able to achieve such with a nursing salary. Because regardless of where we are working as nurses, I honestly do believe that we can be paid better. I always say my employer pays. Yeah, okay, I'm sure we can start now. 30 people are here, that's enough. I always say my employer pays me fair, right? N not fair. I always say I'm not complaining about my employer's salary, but they can do better. Because I know that whatever that they are claiming, wherever they are claiming when it comes to me, they are claiming more than what they are paying me, like way more. So I looked at Uzikona and I was like, Sana, like this nurse, what kind of a nurse is this? One who's going to build ikhaya, bruh, like akakhanga ronda guys. And both homes, the work that she did in both homes, like required a lot of money. I could tell from that post, and I was like, Sanandi, send a friend request, Lentombazana. I think that's how I sent her a friend request. Then from there, I followed her and watched her grow. Like she'll tell you the year. I don't know which year was this, but I was working for government. So basically, we've been online friends for more than 5 years, I think. I was still working for government, and I remember saying, "This is not just an ordinary nurse, Lentombazana. I your ordinary nurse, Lena." And every now and then, she would share bits and pieces of stories I care, and I genuinely believe that. These are the stories that we need to use as blueprint in order to build our own career paths, right? And that is the reason I brought her here. She is very good with financial literacy, but that is not what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be talking about her career journey, her nursing career journey. So let me send her a request and bring her in. Please do share the TikTok live with other people as well so that they can come in and like I always so that you guys can have access to it and be able to reference. Pelekas.
Sana, I don't know. Can you guys hear me? It's
We
my
can
first time
hear
to use this.
you. We can hear you.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Mulweni.
Hi, Mambelunjani.
Dear Pila, see you. And Dine stress, guys, and I have huge stress. I came to Durban for Comrades Marathon. Now I forgot the diary that I wrote everything that I was gonna speak about today, but I'm not worried. I think I'll just go with the flow and you just ask me questions. Or if anyone has a question, then I'll just answer.
Okay, give on bed. Because so normally what I do is I would let you tell your story, right? And we listen to you, and then
Okay.
questions come at the end once you are done telling your story. Because as if unlando yokumane sukuphazamisa, you know, like interrupting you while you are talking, and then you lose your train of thoughts. So we
I got
avoid
it.
Then the questions will come later on.
Okay. Thank you, Z. Thank you so much for giving me this platform. It really means a lot to me.
Okay, thank you.
Let me greet everyone again, the 4649 people that are here. Molweni, I'm quickly gonna introduce myself. My name is Ikona Lupondo. I am 33 years old. I stay in Ladysmith and I work for South African National Blood Service. So I will start with my journey as a nurse. Growing up, oh, sorry guys. I'm the sister in charge.
Yeah, I want
I'm
people to have
the
that. I want people to have that in the back of their mind as you are telling this story. Okay,
Yes.
ndifuna siqale apha, right? I want to know ukuthi growing up, was nursing the first career that you wanted to get into? And if it was, or if it wasn't, how then did you get into nursing?
Okay, thank you so much for the question, Z. Nursing has always been my number one career that I wanted to take. Why? I grew up, my mother was a home carer. And from being a home carer, she was unompilo. I don't know what do you call it in English. Unompilo wasekuhlaleni.
Caregiver, yeah.
So, yes, a caregiver. So I saw her helping people. And sometimes I would help her count maybe bandages that she will use and TB treatment that she will go and distribute like to give other the patients around the community. So I was passionate and I really loved helping my mom through that journey. And I think the one thing that hit hard was my father getting sick when I was 13 years old. He had a diabetic and his one knee was amputated. So I saw how my mother was taking care of my father and we used to help her with taking care of Utata. I just wanted that. I wanted to be a nurse, but at that time I didn't know that there were different kinds of nursing. I didn't like my mom, I thought she was a nurse. I only knew when I was older that she was actually a caregiver. She didn't have like a qualification to be an ENA or to be an enrolled nurse. She was just a home carer. Yes.
So you finish matric and already you know that you want to do nursing. That's how it was.
That's how it was. Let me tell you something, the funny part about this, as I told you guys, I never knew that there's different kinds of nursing. So matric, we went to the what you call this when you go to universities and you go for career exhibition. Yeah, we went for career exhibition. I didn't give even though I knew I wanted to be a nurse, but I was so fascinated with other health professions like physiotherapist and doctor. So I didn't give much attention now on the nursing side when I went for a career exhibition. So I wanted to know about the others, you see. So matric came, so we were applying. Fortunately, I went to a Christian boarding school, so they did everything for us. So they applied on our behalf. Our parents just signed the documents and everything. So come January, now after matric, we got our results. Come January, my principal calls me and she says, "You must go to CPUT on the 8th of January and go to this who and who person, because you are accepted." So I went there. When I got there to CPUT, I went to this so and so, and then she told me, "Okay, you are taken. You have to go to you come back here tomorrow again to do your student card and everything." So I went, met some few friends. Come the what you call this, the first week of university. So at the back of my mind, I thought I'm just gonna study 1 year and go to work. Initially, why I thought of this is because when I went for career exhibition, my mind was just fascinated now about other healthcare professions. I didn't give my 100% a focus on nursing. So now when the lecturer said in the next coming 4 years, we're going to focus, and I'm like, 4 years.
Yo, the shock of your life.
Shockest of my life. I was so shocked. I was really shocked. But when I looked at the other students around me, they were not shocked. I was the only one who was shocked that I will be at this facility for 4 years.
How was undergrad for you?
Undergrad was challenging, guys. I don't want to lie. Undergrad was challenging for me in a way that, besides the books, I felt freedom. Why I'm saying it, I went to in high school, I went to a Christian boarding school, so everything was strict there. There's time to do devotions, there's time for prayer, there's time to read, there's time to eat. So when I went to varsity and staying at the res, I wanted to have a taste of everything that I didn't have a taste of when I was still in high school. I wanted to fit in, you see. I wanted to fit in. So what happened in my first year, I failed my first semester because now I was just all over the place. So second semester, I did pass. But now when I came back the following year, I was only gonna do the first semester, and then the second semester I stayed at home. It was harsh, guys. It was harsh. Now I look shiny, bengihleka, woyisakele, yeah, kind of things, you see. And also my mother, because I was the first person to go to university at home, they had high hopes. They felt disappointed, very disappointed. But at the end of the day, they supported me as my family.
So you then, after you were home for that 6 months, you then went back.
And then I went back to say I went back to do my second year. Hi guys, ngaphinda ngabaphoqa abazali.
I'm so, you know what? I am very happy that you are telling all these details because I also have student nurses here. So I am so happy that you are telling all these details. Also, when Z, I always say people need to know some of the things that we went through in order for us to get where we are. Because I don't want people seeing Kaibo, oh Zanele kumnandi kumthebelele, oh zikhona kumnandi kumthebelele. Like, because now when people go through your Facebook or your Instagram, people look at you and think, yo, Zikona have it easy, or Zikona kumnandi life. Because we don't know these things that you are telling us that you once stayed home for 6 months. Personally, I didn't know all of that, you know. So I'm so glad that you are actually showing us the ins and the out of the womb, like of the journey in order to become the woman that you are. Waphinda
Abazali. And you know what's funny? When we started our first year, one of the lecturers told us that, yay, idepo nenari must be your friends. And depo and nari were not my friends. And you know what happens when a depo and nari start are not your friends? I got pregnant, guys. I got pregnant in second semester of second year. There's something about these semesters.
Ekhaya.
Hey, abazali. Hey, hi. And yes, guys, true that. I found out that I was pregnant during it was, I think it was gonna be December exams, around November. Yeah, I found out I was pregnant around November, October that time. And when I found out I was pregnant, I found out on a Tuesday, and on Friday I'm writing GNS
I was
paper.
hoping you're not gonna say GNS because that module.
I was writing GNS, my dear.
Did you pass it?
See, that we are not 38%. It's stress. And mind you, the baby daddy is also a student, and he was in Switzerland to do his practicals. And yay, it was chaotic. It was chaotic. But I failed. And I wanted to go home on that Tuesday. But as I was walking to go and catch a taxi, I almost got hit by a car, because my mind was just all over the place. So I just told myself, okay, no, let me just go back to res and call my sister, my big sister, and tell her, so that by the time I go home after writing on Friday, then at least my mother knows the situation. So when I got home on Friday, she knew the situation, and some of the family members, extended family members, we were two ladies in my street that were doing nursing. One was doing nursing at UWC, and me, I was doing it at Nkomalan. So when this pregnancy thing came up, they were sort of like, uzogqithwa ngubani?
Oh, that
Uyabo?
comparison.
Yes, yeah, like my comparison about uzogqithwa ngubani, you see all those things. Because last year I was home for 6 months, and then the following year I got pregnant. So it was sort of too much for my family. Luckily my stomach was not big, so I was able to hide it from the lectures and from the mentors. I'm also I think I'm also glad that I didn't have enemies or people that I'm not speaking to at varsity, because I think if I had, they would have went to the lectures and told them that I was pregnant. You see, I remember, guys, yes, I remember doing my practicals. I was 8 months pregnant. My friends were bigger than me, like they were wearing size 38 and 40. So for midwifery, I had to wear a shirt. Yeah, chomiana. I had to wear one on my friend's shirt
Nobumenemene
to the practice. We want to pass. So now in this tiny room with the bed, with the patient and the scenario and everything, it's just me and two lectures. Guys, that 20 minutes was the 20 minutes of life and death. But I managed to pull through, and they never saw anything. They didn't see anything. Come June, my EDD was the 22nd of June. And my last paper for midwifery was the 22nd of June. Hey, I never spoke tongues when I was praying, man. It was my first time to speak tongues that time, telling God that this baby mustn't come out before I write this exam. Nyani ke, guys, if you consistent and then you were tandaza, God does answer our prayers. I went to write that paper. I was the first one to get into that classroom. The paper started at 8 o'clock. I think we finished around 12. It was a 3 or 4 hour paper, and I started to have my labor pains 5 p.m. same day I gave birth at 10 p.m.
Hi,
at
hi,
night.
hi,
Yes, that is God.
So you hid the entire pregnancy until the last day where you were writing your final exam?
9 months full. I gave birth naturally on a Friday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Umtana wawisa inkaba. My friend called me. I was saying that the mentors are asking about you because I was stationed at Mobri Maternity Hospital. I was pregnant while the date is while I was a midwifery student. I delivered 15 babies while I was still pregnant. Midwifery was inside of my tummy while I was, yes. I went back to varsity after 1 week of giving birth. Back to practicals, night shift with episiotomy and. Oh, do we have male nurses? Yes, sorry.
Ubazuti, sorry. Most ngababa switcharayo.
Exactly. Yeah, that's how my undergrad went. After that, guys, I had to focus. I couldn't disappoint my parents again. I had to focus and umtanam. I remember this Sunday, I was still at home and my mother asked me, Uba, why are you lapa? At the back of my mind, I thought, Uba, we are daughter with a baby, you see. So I started to pack izinto zami nezomntana. Now I'm gonna go to the baby day day. And my mother asked me, why are you packing the clothes of zomntana? Isikolo sinabani. So that's when I knew, Uba, okay, no, she's saying go back to school. Because you came back with a degree that has eyes before the paper degree. That's what she said.
What about Tata Leia Pepper and Funa
Air Pepper? Is she Elina Meso? In Omlom.
Oh, guys. Yeah, I see a shaky sir, but something from this story when it was happening. But see a shaky sir.
Yeah, guys, and it was tough. Finished fourth year, and then we had Ubana. There is a shortage of EE placements in the Western Cape. We were like close to 40 nurses from UWC and Nkomalang didn't have EE placements. So come 2015 April, now we're graduating. Yo. Ababahle abantu. Ababahle abantu sana. Yo, guys, mna I had to go to, I don't know if Cape Town people know, in the way to Senyanga Junction. I had to go to Enyanga Junction. Go crap. Yo, crap up something nice and formally in Zoihlamba and wear it to the graduation. I wore secondhand clothes with graduation, but my aunt came through for inwele, and I didn't do makeup. I was just simple, nje, but I came back home with my qualification, regardless the circumstances.
Yeah, and I think I want to say this. I don't know how many graduations you've had already, but every time you graduate, I see your pictures. And Sana, you matter the looks in your graduations. Now it makes sense.
My last graduation was like 3 weeks ago. Why? Ndibulele.
You were fine.
As a sister in charge, ndibulele. Things have changed.
You were fire, Sana Lam. But then you guys graduate at the beginning of the year, ne? Like early in the year.
Yes.
So you were not
placed. We graduated on the 15th of April 2015 and we finished our qualification December 2014.
Yeah, so you guys don't have money during that time because Tina says graduating was September, so you have become safe and all that.
Yeah, those who had placements, they started in February, so they had money. So now I was part of the 45, 40 something nurses that didn't have comm serv positions in the Western Cape. It
Oh,
was
yeah.
tough. And I have a 1-year-old baby at home.
So, wawuhlele ekhayeni from early until up to your place. You were just at home waiting for the government to find
I
positions for
was
you.
waiting. Yes. What did they do is that they checked other provinces if they have any positions for us. And luckily, Northern Cape said, give us all those nurses. And at that time, we were so desperate. We just needed to work because it was not nice now being at home. And on the 1st of February, I remember I just deactivated my, not that I was jealous, I deactivated my account because I was sad seeing my fellow classmates doing their first days at school, at work, I'm sorry. They're doing their first days at work, like taking pictures, checking in Khayelitsha Hospital. You see, or Groote Schuur Hospital, and you are here sitting at home, which is umntanakho. You're just miserable. And the thing is, I'm the first graduate ekhaya, kujongwe nakum. Yeah, I understand. And my mother was old when I started my first year. My mother was 60 years already, so she was only giving me 300 rand from her pension, SASSA pension. And when the baby came, I never got that money again because now the money she had to take care of umntan. Yeah, but
Yeah. Had so now you get a placement to Northern Cape. Do you know where Northern Cape is? Have you been to Northern Cape before?
oh, hey guys, 15 June, 15 April, I graduate. To 20th April, an email comes through. It's a contract, comm serv contract in the Northern Cape, Namakwa district. The name of the place that I'm gonna work at, it's called Pofadder Clinic. And I'm thinking to myself, Pofadder, it's a name of a snake, first of all. And Namakwa, when you think Namakwa, you think of wine. And I'm like, hey. I took my phone, I Googled the place. Yo, I said, there's nothing green. I checked the town is just one street with Pep and OK grocery store and one Standard Bank. Yo, I was like, really, God, this is the best that you can give. And but I good to beggars can't be choosers. So I was like, as long as I'm going to earn a salary and the language that is spoken strictly, I mean strictly Afrikaans, strictly Afrikaans. So now I'm just confused. I'm thinking, should I go? Should I wait for Western Cape? But they try to look for us in other provinces. Surely there's nothing here. And now I'm a mother, the child is young, I need to go to work. So I just signed the contract and yeah, we started on the 1st of May, 2015.
You found yourself traveling to a different province. Imali nayo uzofika uhlale
You
phi?
see, imali ayikho. Andithi umama upeyisasa. My sisters, they're working at restaurants. Like they're getting paid like almost 600 per week. Imali ayikho. Now I'm packing. We were five. There was five of us going to the Namakwa district. We organized a transport, so we are Khayelitsha. I stayed in Philippi, Iqethukume is a Philippi, and then now we're going to Springbok. When I checked kilometers, it's 700 kilometers away from home
My word.
in the middle of nowhere. Umama only had imali yobhatala the transport and that was 500 rand. Ne-R50 uba ndikwazi nje ndithenge noba zii-chips ne-drink endleleni. And the words that she gave me, wathi mntanam andinanto but ndikuhambisa nomoya ingcwele. That's what my mother said. Now I was at school for couple of 1 year, some odd. I left the child, now I'm leaving the child again. Umncinci kumama ndiyozama impilo. Yeah, understand.
Hey, khawubambe, khawubambe, because I don't know. You know, you and I have never had a one-on-one conversation. Yeah, like, and I don't know. I think there are probably people who knows you here, people who've been following you. Yeah, man, you don't look like you don't look like the story you are giving. And I'm saying it for the second time. I'm so happy that you are giving us all of this that we went through, because as nurses, most of the times we get so discouraged easily. Like into yokuba, yo, hi, isanki, itini, I'm nandiyayeka. But like hearing you telling this story and also looking at where you are now, sana, hi, and yes, but like, yo, I sana, like, intlizwe yam uyithathile.
Yeah, it's life, Zee, sister Zee. It's life. Now when I look back, and I'm thankful for umama giving me those words, because now when you leave home, you're all alone in the middle of nowhere. Your family is far. You are come to uzolilela kuye, uzolilela phi kulo moya ingcwele. Because at that time, there's the only person that is closer to you. So I arrive at this place. I don't know anyone. My Afrikaans is not Afrikaansing. Is I arrive, yeah. Luckily, guys, I just want to tell you something. We were treated as VIPs in the Northern Cape. I don't want to lie. In a way that the previous comsaves of 2015 sebe permanent in 2014 sebe permanent 2015, they were jealous of us. They were jealous in a way that they didn't understand why the people from the Western Cape, they are treated so differently, and we did the same course and everything. When we arrived there, Satatwa, you transport it. We arrived in the middle of the night, 1 a.m. The transport dropped us at the engine garage in Springbok. We were taken, and we were taken by a transport from the Department of Health there. They took us to a BNB. We stayed at the BNB for a week.
Wow.
The department paid.
Yo, Department of Health.
The Department of Health paid for our stay for that week of orientation and everything. From there, they told me I can't go straight to Pofa there. They still are fixing the state house for me to stay in it. They're installing the wardrobes and everything. So I had to stay, I had to work in Springbok for 6 months while they were fixing whatever they were fixing in Pofadder. Pofadder and Springbok is 350 kilometers apart.
Sure.
These places in the Northern Cape, they far, very far apart. So we're working here, we're working at a very small hospital with few nurses and doctors. And if there's a referral, the referral is from Springbok to Upington. That's like almost 400 kilometers away. So if there's a referral, they always took us Comserve nurses to take our patients with the ambulance. So you can imagine sitting in an ambulance at the back with a patient for 400 kilometers.
It was
tough. That was tough. It was tough. It was tough.
Yeah.
Very, very tough. And it's funny that after a few years, I worked in Upington, the same hospital I was traveling to from Springbok the past few years. That's how God works. Like, he, izinto zakhe ziyamangaza. Like, he's a God of miracles. So I worked there for 6 months. Then I went to Pofadder Clinic. Guys, it yo. Hey. Oh, hey, ndafika pa. When I got there, guys, there is an old nurse that is gonna retire in 1 month. As a retire nje in 1 month, you know that what what does that mean? It means that I'm going to be the professional nurse of that clinic.
The only one.
Yes, and there's only one ENA. There's no staff nurse.
You.
I had to grow, guys. I
Sure,
had to
it.
grow, and if too much, and you know what, Z? I think I posted on my Facebook few weeks ago. Yeah, before my graduation, that God qualifies the unqualified. I held the management position for 5 years without a management qualification. Why I'm saying that? Because in that 4 months, I'm still a com-serv nurse, but I was in charge of a clinic. I'm a com-serv, but I'm seeing all the patients. I was seeing like almost 25 patients a day. And it was structured like this way. Mondays, it's antenatal. Tuesdays, it's chronic patients. Wednesday, we travel 80 kilometers out of town to the farms. We have a mobile clinic. Nalapo, I'm the only PN. Comserve PN. Guys,
Before you started, I wanted to say to you, I can see how passionate you are about management. Earlier on the live, I wanted to say, if there's one thing I know about you is that you are very passionate about management,
Yes.
facility management. But I didn't know that it started so early for you in the profession.
So early. It was like 7 months into nursing, like COMSAVE. I was in charge. I was ordering. The clinic was mine because now there was no PN available at the clinic.
Yo,
And
and
every time when I voiced out, hi guys, I need someone, I need a senior professional, and send someone that can assist me. Yeah, we sent a position in Kimberley, we're waiting for approval. Zaqengqeleka, zaqengqeleka inyanga until I finish my comm serve. So the last 5 months of my comm serve, I was in charge of a clinic with a enrolled nursing assistant.
I want to ask you a question about that. Would you want God not to put you in that position again? Like given another opportunity, going back, would you say to God, I don't want to manage a clinic as a comserve? Would you say that?
I think I would say that because now I was working under pressure, and now I'm an all-rounder. Because now remember, ENA can't do much, cannot do much. So I felt the pressure on my shoulders. And remember, I'm 24 years old. I just started working. I also needed guidance. You understand? So, but now that I'm in charge, I'm a sister in charge, years later, I felt like that journey was like training me for the future. And at that time, I didn't know. Bengayazi. 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 So, yeah, now I'm back home. Come serve, pelile.
absorb you guys.
What happened is that I remember being called by the district Tuataba sister Bakulube district, and she was saying to me, I'm doing an interview over the phone. Yeah, bo. What happened is that they were absorbing us, but amapepa ayengekho at that time. The papers were not there. So they didn't want me to leave. They wanted me to keep on working. Remember, there's no sister now at this clinic.
Oh,
they
okay.
wanted me to work without a contract. And I was like, because now this means I'm not gonna get paid. And they were saying, no, we're gonna make sure you remember I'm staying for free at the state house. Yes, I'm staying for free at the state house. There's no money deducted from my salary. So they were just saying, we'll make sure that you have enough grocery. You are well taken care of until upeya, and then those other months ungapeyanga, we will back pay them. So I felt like, no, I'm being used here. So I'm like, no, I'm gonna go home and wait for a contract while I'm home. So this other day in their churches, I'm moonlighting at Khayelitsha Hospital. It was August 2016. Guys, I was called by three HRs. I don't know why they didn't tell each other that who and who is going to call these ones. Who and who is going to call these ones. Because I know three HRs, the son has their phone, and like, congratulations, Sister Lupondo. Congratulations, Sister Lupondo. You are absorbed in Nancy contract. Yeah, bo?
Yeah.
So now, Sister Z, I'm sitting here. Sisondele ku December. And now my savings is pela ke ngoko, because when I came back home, my sister is like, makaka that you were working. I had to buy myself a new bedroom suit. I had to like revamp my bedroom. The change and ascending, change some windows. In fact, if I have a woman, Jake Bekuse, now the savings are depleting. The savings are depleting. Now I'm sitting here. I asked them, is there a sister now there? No, I clinic yava lwa Sister Z when I left.
Ayini guys.
I clinic yava lwa now everyone went to where? To SCHC. Had to walk from elokshini to the CHC, a town. Because the clinic is elokshini.
Our government.
So now I'm going back to the same situation that I left. So now I'm asking God, do I undiphindisela pha moya engcwele? Pha kulandawo undiphindisela pha? Ziyenze njani? Like I was really, really, really confused, but I told them to give me time to think about it. So they gave me a whole month. And in that month, they managed to get a senior professional nurse, a male senior professional nurse. So by the time I signed my contract, we started together, like first days at work together with a senior professional nurse.
Now you're going back to the Northern Cape.
I'm going back to the Northern Cape. I'm going back to that same place they called me Swart Sister. They called me a black sister. I'm going back there. I'm going back to a place that I was so young, I couldn't even go out. First time when I went out, guys, I'm not, this is true. I'm not exaggerating or anything. It is true. That's how small these places are. When I went out, every corner, every time when I look around me, I see my patient. Almost 60% abantu bakula groove. It was my patient.
Why are you groove?
I'm groove because now when I go to the toilet, two ladies or three ladies are waiting for me outside. Sister, cop a beer for me. So my sister, Nkalun Tengeli Bia.
Yo! Yo, Pangela!
Yes! Babo no sister, Galosana Bali Bali. Yo, they respected me. One thing about working in small towns, guys, the people they respect, abantu bafundileyo. Yo! But they do give you the highest. And then this feeling I didn't know. I felt like a doctor because of the respect that I was given. And like in small towns, they really give you that respect because not a lot of people go beyond after matric. Like you do your matric and then usalekaya. Oh, we all funum sebenzi kula pep store we won. Or last standard bank we won, or okay, a grocery store we won. Pa. Yeah, bo. So I came, went back. I worked with this say for a couple of months. And then that was in October 2016. January 2017, I saw this poster saying there will be a blood donation at the church here in Bofader. So I'm like, oh, this day I'm working, yabo. But I will on my lunchtime I will come and donate blood, yabo. Guys, let me tell you something. When I went there, I'm wearing my uniform, remember? So now when I got in there, the sister that works for the blood company, the first thing she asked when I walked inside there, she asked me, what are you doing here? Like she's asking, what am I doing in this small town in the middle of nowhere? And I'm so young. You understand? So I'm like, no. And then I told her the whole story. And funny enough, she also did her undergrad at Nikomalan. So nditsale gazi guys, I took pictures and then I went back to work. That was in February, March, April, May, I donated again. And then June, this sister wearing the same uniform, the other sister now wearing the uniform at SANPS, came to my office and now ndikomba yuthi xa wami noba ndiyagula kwenzeka ntoni igazi lami litheni. And then she's like, no, and ugugile ke sana. She's like, no, it's not about your blood donation. I just came to tell you that I'm retiring end of this month. Please apply for this position. Just like that.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Hi, boy.
She came straight into my office. When I saw the uniform, I thought there is something wrong with my blood. And she said, no, whatever is wrong with your blood, the head office will contact you, not us. Now I just came to tell you that they are retire end of this month. Ngelu apply for this position. My man, I guess he said, and it took 2 years experience. And I got 2 years experience in the qualify of October. Yeah. Ku-aplaya online ke sana ndiqhele izinto zezethu ntontoni zikagovernment mna ndizazinto za-online yey ndalova emsebenzini because I can't yey Jesus. My laptop was giving me imagudumane vibes. I can't yebethunana. I asked my then boyfriend to assist me with this applying online because iyaphelwa le position namhlanje ebusuku.
Hayibo.
Danyinda sobabini
yahamba iCV. Yeva. Now I'm waiting. That was Friday. Monday, ndisemsebenzini, HR called me saying, yazi into xa iseye yakho sister ziye yakho. The HR called me and told me there's only one page that is attached here. Please send me your full CV on my email. See, in this world, 2024, you'll never get that. Your CV is not there. Say a greater.
Disqualified.
Exactly my point. I dear Butuzela, ke ngoku ingase ndihambe kwalapha emsebenzini yazi mna one of the patient people I don't have patience guys ndivele ndiye I panic a lot I do panic a lot ndiyanyinda ndiyanyinda nangoku ndivale macango ndithi guys ndiyaxoka kwi-patients ndithi ndiyeza do not disturb ndizama usenda and now I'm trying to send.
Ufuna usecure omnye umsebenzi bashiyapho.
Pasi 2 years experience ayikadibani. But something inside of me is telling me apply for this position. Okay, I apply. Yahamba nyani CV. Dalinda. Dabizwa for interview. Interview is 180 kilometers away. And okay. Namoto. And now, Moto, who's gonna take me there? A boyfriend, Sebenza. I can't drive. Hey, turns out that only landlord, I'm my landlord. Now I moved out to Kuyikwi State House. I'm renting a flat in town. So I asked my landlord, my retired landlord, what? No, it's not a problem. 1.5. Return. He's driving a Fortuner. So my then boyfriend did pay for that 1.5 for me to go and do an interview. Hi, Kelsey. Hey, I think I overdressed my name. And this is my first interview ever in lifetime. I never had the interview.
Do you know what questions are they gonna ask you?
Not the corner calling you. Remember, I told you guys about the sister who asked me, "What are you doing here?"
Yeah.
Now I googled the phone numbers of the donor center there, and then I told them on this date that make sister here in Pofadar. Oh, no, it's sister Killian. That's in Kelayen. Me asking Sister Killian to be zero for interview, which are questions that they're gonna ask. The same Sister Killian will be on the panel. I didn't know.
Johnny.
The same Sister Killian. No, she did not. She just said no. It's just gonna be general questions. It's not something hectic. Yeah, but so now when I got there, the sister I'm here, when they explain this position, the person I'm going to report to, it's Sister Killian.
No, man, she saw you. Yo!
So I get guys in the Buduzel and I'm him. No, the questions were not bad, Shem. I don't wanna lie. And they also like, I think because they were asking, they asked other questions like scenario questions, and then they were asking questions like, what is the normal range for blood pressure? What is different types of blood groups? You see all those things, yeah, bo. So I thought I did well, yeah, bo. And It was a mobile. It was a mobile clinic position. So initially they wanted a manpower. Yabo. But again, ingathi zange bayifumane because they called me on the 20 something of June, but in the fumane position. Mind you, Z, remember, I'm on at the 2 years experience they wanted. I got hlangan. Izohlangana ngo-October and we in July now I'm working my lentus in notice. I'm gonna start there the 1st of August. I got quali still the 24 months.
Okay, Mandibuze, do you know what this South African National Blood Bank is? Do you know what it is? Have you heard about it before?
I'm for me because now I don't.
A government post for Yona. Do you know it? Like leaving your permanent government post and going to join a company. Do you know it?
I don't know anything about this company. The only thing I know is that they're just traveling all around South Africa by donating sangekaze because I myself as a donor, sebesendiyazi ba. Aba bantu into abayenzayo ukutsala igazi cha yabo, so there is nothing much that they're doing and about dealing with patients. They don't deal with coughs, they don't deal with izilonda and all those things. Now after ndindi I got the position, now I'm doing my notice kwa government. I had that anxiety uba now this is a private company, it's an NPO, and now I'm leaving government. And let me tell you, I have aunt she's a she was she retired now, a prosecutor, a mtata. She's all about government. In her entire 46 years of service, she worked for government. So anything it depends on no private. Hi, oh,
I
hi, we have a
understand.
strong thing. I ain't a value.
True.
So
And
now
I
she's also.
understand because bendubuza lo mbuzo because that's what we get, particularly from like closer families. Because even me, when I left government, my parents were like, "Are you mad? Do you understand
Exactly.
ukuba government is the ultimate
You
goal?
see,
Like you are
exactly.
living to do what, you know?"
Now I have this fear, is this what I'm supposed to do? Nditini, the confused, the and yes, no, but what I know is that I'm gonna get paid more than I'm getting paid up. Do I understand the is in those pension and provident fund? You see, those are two different thing kind of things. And as into, but now I felt like in the I needed a change. I needed a change, and if change has to come by taking risk, then let it be. Let it be. So I just took a leap of faith in that in Dizobona Pambi. I packed my bags, Dabashi. Quite government and started in this new company. Yonke into different. Everything was so different. I'm not saying by government we don't give good customer service, but Ipaya, you treat the clients as ama VIPs.
Mambele, kuthiwa
Yeah.
we must not speak isiXhosa. Yes, they understand we are both Xhosa.
Sorry.
We are sorry, guys. We are so sorry.
I'm so sorry, guys.
We are sorry. We got
So,
in the way.
now I started there. Things are so different. Remember, this is an NPO. NPO meaning that the client is giving in money to the company. So in order for SANBS to make money, people, the donors must donate blood. So you have to treat donors with the utmost best of customer service. You have to go all out.
for ama donors akho uyabo. So napaya guys, I don't want to lie, there was challenges because I was working at the mobiles, ne? But there were some days that I had to work at the donor center, and our sister in charge was at donor center. I'm so sorry guys if there's white people here. Wailibulu, she was white, and she was whitey, and she only had Rangupa one.
Yeah.
She only had midwifery bar. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now, remember when I work at the donor center, now donors will come in, white donors. So they didn't understand their sister is way older than me, but she has one bar. And then there is me who's black and young, and I have three bars. You understand?
Yeah.
So there was sort of some discrimination here and there, but I was like, okay, when I work at the donor center, I'm like, but God, I want this kind of space. I don't want to offload and load consumables. You see, yeah. Those things need manpower, but we were there. We had to assist men and do all this offloading and loading. But at the back of my mind, I knew that I wanted that kind of environment. I want to be in an aircon environment. I want to wear high heels. I want to be classy, yeah. You see, at work. So even though I was not treated well when I was working at the donor center, but initially, at the back of my mind, I told myself that I want this kind of environment.
So the treatment to you was not discouraging you from getting what you want. And this is what I love about your story. It's how with every encounter you had, you were getting exposure. Firstly, you went to donate your blood and you were not looking for a job, but you were exposed to that registeredness and the work that she does. And that ended up lending you this particular position. The position was the lowest, I guess, in terms of hierarchy. You started as like working in the field, which was, you were exposed to the field. You got that position of working in the field. And at the same time, then that position led you to be exposed to the donor clinic. Now you are like, oh, okay, there's also the space, and this is the space that I would like to be in. I'm seeing how goal orientated you are throughout this thing, because in career building, it's so easy to be distracted and to lose the focus because of all the noise that tends to happen around you. For instance, Leyokba, you got discriminated. Some people would be like, I'm done. I'm out of here. This is not going to work for me anymore. And this is it. Sure.
So for me, I never got discouraged. I think when we face difficulties in life, it's either they shaping us, they molding us for the future or the present situations that we are facing. Because for me to have three bars, even when I told you guys when I started my journey, I didn't even know that I'm gonna be a sister. I thought I'm just gonna do 1 year and go to work.
Yeah.
So it was a blessing to me to even have three bars after the 4 years. You understand? So now the other donors didn't understand. I had to just tell them how it worked. You see, that I just did 1 4-year course and then I got done. Then yeah, she was ENA first, and then an enrolled nurse, and then bridging, and you see. So for her, it was a little bit longer because it was during the 1970s and 1980s, and now things have changed. So I'm here. I'm exposed now to the company. I'm seeing better opportunities. I'm seeing other positions that there's actually other positions that you don't even deal with the donors. You are behind the scenes. Positions like a donor deferral officer, a DDO, all those who are deferred, you call them, you contact them, and you
you defer them for a particular thing, like maybe the person has high blood pressure or the person is pregnant. And we have AMA medicalization officers. Those ones are dealing with those ones that cannot, are not able to donate anymore because of maybe they contracted HIV or syphilis or hepatitis B or C. You see, so now I'm exposed to the company. I want to know more. I want to, now I want to just get to know what the behind the scenes are. You see, now, months went by. I didn't like traveling anymore. I was like, I have to get a position at the donor center. It doesn't have to be here where I am, but I want a position at the donor center. And an opportunity came, Ladysmith Donor Center. Guys, let me tell you something. I only knew after I started at Ladysmith Donor Center that I was the only candidate that applied for that position. Why? Now I'm far away. I'm in Upington. I don't know what's happening in KZN. I don't know what's happening in Joburg. I'm just there. I'm very far away from people. It was because of the previous manager. People didn't want to work under that previous manager. So that's why people never applied for that position. And remember, when she started working for SNBS, she worked somewhere else, and then she worked at KZN. So now I heard rumors it's because of her that people never wanted to apply for the position. But yeah, I got it anyway, and we worked well together until she looked for other greener pastures.
So you left now from Upington and went into KZN.
I left Upington now after 1 year as a donor care officer. I got a position now as a clinic supervisor of Ladysmith Donor Center. So I took the position, packed my bag.
Wait. So when you left Upington, were you working in the donor clinic or you were still working in the field?
I was still working at the mobiles.
And then when you get in Ladysmith, you're getting in as what?
As a clinic supervisor of the donor center.
Hi, Bo.
Yes. I got what I wanted from God.
Like, Sana, please give us your prayer. Someone says they can't hear us. I don't know. Is it me? Guys, can you hear us? Boy mom says she can't hear us. But I think other people can hear you. Yeah, like it doesn't make sense. Mm. So you from mobile to supervisor, like Komane says, from mobile to supervisor, just like that.
Yes, just like that. Kanjalo nje, guys. I don't want to lie. They just wanted a 1 year experience as a donor care officer. I already had a 1 year experience. And guys, when I that position was re-advertised over and over. And it was re-advertised in a point that they didn't want a 1 year experience anymore. They wanted 6 months experience. So I did apply for that position, and when they said, when they put it on the advert, they said it's gonna be a designated position, meaning when you start, you're going to work for 1 year with a lower salary while they training you. After that 1 year, then you get the salary that you were supposed to get as a clinic supervisor. But when I left, guys, I had a car. I just bought it 2 months, and I traveled with it. I think I had fatigue or something, but I was involved in a car accident, and I was only left with 1 hour for me to get to Ladysmith. I survived the accident, but the car was written off. So when I started this position, I was devastated. I was booked off for 2 weeks, but after 5 days, I told my manager that I want to report on duty because I'm stressed out. I don't want to be in this house anymore. I want to be around people. So throughout those things that happened, January, that was in December, January, the boss, the big boss, came to my office now with the contract that I was supposed to sign after 1 year. I only signed it after 1 month. And I got the salary that I was supposed to get after 1 year. I got it after 1 month.
What was it? What was it, Zikona? Was it, what made those people to make that decision, according to you? Was it your dedication?
I don't know. Maybe they I don't, I really don't know. Remember when this post was re-advertised over and over, I already had 1 year experience, but I only applied when they said 6 months experience. So I don't know if it's because I don't have 6 months experience, I already have 1 year experience, or is it because they felt pity for me of what happened? I don't know. I don't want to lie. I don't know. Or is it God wiping my tears away? It's very painful to lose a car, a brand new car, in 2 months' time. You see, so that's what happened. And yeah, just touching on what you said about me now, a journey of building my homes and whatsoever, I'm just gonna touch a little bit, but I'm not gonna go deep because this is all about my career, not financials. I decided not to buy another car, so whatever I was paying towards the car installment, insurance, and the tracker, now I was saving it every month. Yeah. I was saving it every month. I got my stock files. I got my bonus also. The money that I had by December, I had close to 150K. Yeah. So I decided, no. My mother now is staying in Eastern Cape full time. So let me do something that will generate more money, like money monthly, not for her to wait for me to send her money every month. So I built two flats, rental flats with own end suits, like own bathroom, built-ins, kitchenettes, and a wardrobe, two of them in Cape Town, at home in Cape Town, so that I my mother can have money and not wait from me, you see. So that's one of the biggest things I did when I started this position, is to build those two rental flats. And I was already building my home already in Cape Town. My other problem that I had is not doing one thing and finishing it. I was just all over. And for me to get a mentor after, someone to shape me and tell me, no, you have to do this and this. And then after, when you are done, and then you move forward. Because I think one of the mistakes I did was to buy a car while I was not finished with my mother's house in the Eastern Cape. I think that's one of the problems I did in life, but I'm a better person now. I know better. So yeah, that is it. My position is clinic supervisor, né? But I don't like the name. Sorry, guys. I don't like the name because I feel like sometimes we were given that name because they don't want to pay us what is due to us. Guys, I'm the sister in charge of that clinic. Why I'm saying so? You will never see a supervisor that is in charge of cost centers. that is worth millions. You will never see a supervisor that approves leaves,
yeah,
maternity leave, whatever leave. You will never see a supervisor doing that. You will never see a supervisor attending executive meetings.
Yeah. You are an operational manager of the facility.
In other words, my love, yes.
My dear,
yes.
At your young age, Sana.
I am, yeah.
For a corporate company.
For a corporate company. I am.
Which yes. year was it when you built, you know, as you and I have been talking on WhatsApp, I was contemplating on also bringing you back to come and speak to us as nurses. Gemali Ntombi. And yes. I think because I know we're probably about to wrap up, I also want you just to give a bit of your academic background. But I wanted to say this to you. I thought, as I was thinking, there's so much to talk about when it comes to Ubukona, because she wears different hats, not like how I view you. You know, there's the financial literacy girl to me, because that's the girl that I followed, actually, the financial literacy girl. And also, yes. there's a girl that I see has built a solid, concrete, successful career for herself in nursing, yes. particularly in management. And Z, we always say, oh, we no longer want to be operational managers because Department of Health will give you the position after 40 years. And this,
yes.
today's conversation showed us that if you've got passion for managing an organization, a clinic or a hospital, you can actually also go outside and seek those greener pastures. They don't need that years of experience. You can be an operational manager somewhere else. I thought, should I bring this girl as and I think I want them to tell me that I should bring you back. You come and you talk to us about finances as nurses.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you started the building process while you had just started this particular position. I don't think you were earning the same the money that you are currently earning. So as far as good, speaking closer, but you didn't have money at the onset, but you still managed to push projects and make sure that you do stuff for yourself. I think I want to bring you for that conversation. Guys, do you want me to
I would love to be part of that conversation, because I've been working for how many years now, from post-comserve 2016 17 18 19 20 21 22 23, so 8 years later I managed to build two homes. I managed to buy two homes for myself, and I'm driving an SUV. 8 years.
8 years.
8 years. Yeah. Two title deeds, two homes built from scratch, and an SUV. So it's doable. I'm a nurse, and it's doable. So I would love to come back and talk about that, and also talk about the importance of having a mentor, because I feel like if as I said, I was just all over the place, and as soon as I got this person and I paid a certain amount for the whole year, that person managed to shape me into different things.
People want you back, so I think you and I will talk about that on WhatsApp, and then we just decide when are we going to do it, because I want this particular life to be a segment on its own and to take its glory. I want us to go to your postgraduate studies, and also the couple of short courses that you've done that you feel, Uguti, they were so significant and they made a tremendous impact on your career, because I know you've been graduating, Ntombi. Sana and go in the stage.
Last week I was graduating for the third time. Yes. Okay.
Yeah. Qualification. What else did you do?
Okay, if you remember, guys, when I started now as working for this blood company, I saw other like positions behind the scenes positions. So there was this one I was telling you about, that you become a medical liaison officer. So now I was like, this name sounds so nice, and now you're working directly with only doctors, like the medical team. So I wanted to know, what qualification do they have to have in order for them to go there? So when they said, no, you just have to have HIV and AIDS counseling and management, because now you have to counsel those patients, those donors and whatsoever. So now, let me tell you something, Z. I don't know now, years later, how I feel about this this qualification, because I did it, I think during COVID time, yeah. I didn't know that Stellenbosch University has this kind of qualification.
The HIV management.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So now I was just eager. I just wanted to study. So I studied HIV management and counseling way at Boston College. And remember, yes. And remember, it's not so deep, like, yeah. Yes. Like, so now it's a higher certificate. And the other thing that makes me very, very sad about the qualification that I did, it was 29,000 rand. Looking at the fees of Stellenbosch University, there's a little difference.
True.
So, but it happened that I got that higher certificate from Boston College, and then the company said, there is money. If you want to study anything, there is money. So I did a short course with Avert Digital. I did operations management. The company paid, I think it was 18,000 rand. And then that was a short course. And then I just recently graduated now with advanced diploma in management with Regent Business School. Why I chose that kind of qualification is because I'm working in a corporate.
Yes, very significant.
Yes. I didn't want to do the management where I'm gonna get a silver bar. I would love to, but I didn't see it as it's gonna take me very far in the corporate.
Yes.
So
yes.
For me, I felt like, no, let me do something different. It was difficult, guys. I don't want to lie, to do accounting and economics and things that I never did, even in matric or in high school. But we learn. And the company paid.
Hi, company.
The company paid, darling. I think also because I think I was listening to one of your lives at some point. People were complaining. I don't know if it was live or something you posted. People were complaining about managers not approving. If you guys have, I think what helps me is that I have good relationship with my executives, my higher managers. So because these applications, I apply, it goes to my line manager. From my line manager, it goes to the zone manager. So if it goes through from those two people, it's done.
And you have a good relationship with them.
Girl, it goes on my WhatsApp. It's taking photos with them today at the Comrades Marathon. I'm like, here's the people that I report to, the executives.
Why am I smelling a promotion, Sana?
Hi, there's no promotion, but another qualification, maybe.
One that is fully paid for.
Yazi, fully paid. Yazi, guys, it's so nice to study and you don't have to worry about fees. Yo!
Mampela sifuna usikhalisa because silala sisisela amanzi izinto sihlala kuzo ngenxa yezi school fees because oh guys sorry for speaking.
I can imagine, guys. I can't be stressing about two bonds and then I have to stress about fees also. I know I'm thanks. Thank you so much.
Yeah, like,
so, guys, I graduated last week. Yo, I was so beautiful. Yo, remember that 22-year-old who graduated wearing secondhand clothes? The one who graduated 3 weeks back, guys, was wearing Steve Madden.
My girl, come on.
I'm just highlighting that the God changes the story. Changes the story.
Yeah. I love your will, you know, I love your will of chasing. I love your will of chasing. I posted a caption on my social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, and LinkedIn last week, and I was reflecting on my own career, and I was saying, someone says employer of the year goes to Sunbus.
Thank you so much.
All employers must learn from Sunbus. But Belaz, I wrote and I said, I remember when I left the government, I remember leaving, not knowing where am I going, not knowing how far am I going to go, not knowing what's out there for me. But I remember walking out and just walking. And the moment I stepped out, I then realized that actually I can go further and further and further. And I was saying on that caption, even today, as I look back now, 4 years ago when I resigned, I'm seeing how far I've come. But I don't think I have comprehended how far I am going, like how far I'm going to grow into the space that I am immersing myself into. And there's a lady who left a comment. I don't think she's a nurse or she wasn't even following me. But this lady left a comment in one of the videos of the conversation we've been having this week. This lady says, it sounds like nursing is a good profession. Uti, I wish I could have studied nursing. It sounds like nursing is a good profession as long as you study. I wish all the 85 people who are here tonight listening to you narrate your story can see what our qualification, just the undergrad, just the undergrad. I wish they can know the power, because the power of our undergrad qualification is the one that produced the woman that you are today.
That is true. That is absolutely true. And there were challenges, guys. It's not all glitz and glam. There will be challenges. And if it was someone else failing first semester of the first year, I couldn't, maybe I should have just went to ShopRite and be a cashier for that 6 months I was staying at home. But I just stayed at home and did nothing, waiting for the following year for me to go back to school. So it's that thing, it comes from within, that you want to do this, you want to chase your dreams, because I'm still that young girl who was helping her mother with those TB patients. I did more advanced than when I was helping my mother, and it was within in me, inside of me, like I wanted to do this. I really wanted to do it. So let me tell you one thing. No one will stop you.
True. Hey, come on.
No one. No one. Not even your family member, not your boyfriend, not your fiance, not your husband, not your friends, not even your kids will stop you.
Sure.
Not anyone will stop you.
Belegazi, thank you. Let's take question. There's someone called Jay here. Uti, what advice can you both give to an ENA student that's aspiring to do RN? Do we have ENA students? Are we having people who are doing ENA? How? Isn't it a phased out course?
Now I just wanted to know where are they studying ENA?
Yeah. Yeah, like Jay, just before we come in with our advices to you, can you just confirm with us where are you still studying? Enrolled nursing. Yes. Oh, sorry. Yeah, enrolled nursing. We want to know where are you still doing it? Or is it EN, enrolled nursing assistant? I mean, EN is no longer there. We don't have it in the country. Oh, in Namibia. Oh, it's in Namibia. Sure. Okay.
Oh,
Bella,
difficult.
yeah, let's come back to you. Just give us maybe a minute and then we will come back to your question. Let us ponder on that because it means we also need to consider you being in Nigeria. Someone says, I wish I can join the corporate world too. You're giving me hope to keep applying. Do you have any advices for applications?
Guys,
Particularly you are working for, any advices in terms of EPV and all that?
Yeah, guys, with my company, firstly, you have to apply at PNET, ne? PNET, make sure what I've noticed is that people are saying I've been applying, I never been called for interview or anything. It's because their profiles are not finished. And those profiles are giving you a percentage. So if your profile is under 100%, you will not get shortlisted. Make sure your profile on PNET is on 100%. And also, there are people that are doing CVs. I don't know what's the name of this thing. It's ST, what, but it must be in line with that ST, what. But we no longer guys doing those CVs, name, surname, date of birth. I
Curriculum
wish
vitae.
I can send a copy of my CV, guys. Then you can sort of check how it go straight to the point. Yeah, but they won't do anything with your criminal record. It's the duty of the company to do those things, to do those checks.
Which basically asayifuni la CV ibhalwe curriculum vitae. Guys, did I lose Belegas? Or did you guys lose me? I think you lost me. Okay, I'll just wait to see you here. Okay, I'm here. It means I lost her. Let me wait. Yeah, I lost her. She's probably gonna come back. Okay, I wanna go back to your questions. Okay, someone says, how can I convert my R171 diploma into a degree? Stop being obsessed with the word degree. You don't have to convert your R171 degree diploma. You need to recognize the power that your R171 diploma holds and the doors that it has, or like the ability that it has to take you to the next step. You don't need to convert. Even the old diploma nurses, I usually hear them, how can I get a degree? Guys, you no longer need degrees. The council says if you have an R171, you just need to get that 1 year midwifery, advanced midwifery course, and then you are on the same level. Not with NQFs, but the same level with the degree students. You have that maroon epaulette with one green bar. Then you can now access your specialities. There is no degree that you need. You do not need a degree. Stay away from the degree. The only qualification you need is the midwifery 1 year program, and then you get into the specialities. From specialities, you get into your master's. From your master's, you get into your PhD. I no longer want to hear people saying they want to convert their diplomas. That when you start saying that to me, it says you are looking down on the qualification that you already have on the hand. And once you look down on what you have on hand, you want to act. Once you get something that looks better, you won't move, Stando-sam. You will not move. Jay from Namibia, I still haven't forgotten about you. Sadiki asked about the requirements of SANBAS. I think Zikona has to take that, but it's registered nurse and 2 years of experience.
That's what she said at the onset of the live. I saw you coming in and I saw that you came late, but I also know you always catch up on YouTube. So you will hear her as she was telling her story. I'm gonna post this during the week on YouTube. So she did say that it's registered nurse and 2 years of experience. That's when she started. I don't know now if the there are changes, but if she comes back, she's gonna confirm that for us. What are the requirements for corporate nursing? Corporate nursing is very broad. I'm also in corporate, but I don't work the same company or the same work that Zikhona does. I don't work the same company or the same work that those corporate medical aid guys I hosted a few weeks ago do. So corporate is too big, and each company will tell you whatever that they want based on the scope of whatever work that they expect you to do. If you want to hear what the medical aides want, you can go on my YouTube channel and watch the live that I did with those guys who were telling us about the corporate in what you call it in medical aids. But where I work, they want experience in HIV. They want you to have a NIMAT on top of your normal diploma, right? And it's an advantage if you have a postgraduate diploma in HIV or in what is the other one? In public health. And also there are other corporates, right, that we don't know, like your BMWs, your there are various corporate companies, and all of them, they will want the requirements will always be different, will be based on what will you be doing as a nurse in their company. Mims says, and there was a lady who showed me how to apply, but fear of leaving Blom. Sana, nisazolamba. That's all I'm gonna say to you. And I also want to say this, right? Guys, working in corporate, also there's that risk of retrenchment. Always bear that in mind. Are we not scared of getting retrenched? I'm personally not scared of getting retrenched. I'm not. I've been retrenched before, and like I'm also anticipating it in the future. Like I know I will experience it in the future. Corporate does that, like it retrenches. And you can ask yourself, then what are we trusting? We're trusting that we are becoming the people that we want to become. Like I have a bigger vision of who I am, and it requires me to walk the route that I'm walking. Like there's no other way that I can say, oh no, let me dodge this one. At least let me take this route. There's no other route. I have to go through this, the retrenchments and all of that. I have to go through that. The relocating from one province to the other, I have to go through all of that for me to become the global leader that I want to become. But if I can hold on to fear and stay and say, me, I want to stay in Rustenburg because I grew up in Rustenburg. I wouldn't have done half the things that I did from last year until now while I'm in Johannesburg. So when I'm saying uzolamba, if you decide that when are you going to be fearful of changing employers, and I don't want to come across as someone who's advocating or pushing nurses to leave DOH. No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying leave an employer that is not appreciating you, leave an employer that is not granting you a platform for you to grow, for you to learn, you leave. Please share isiVi yakho. I will talk to her to share isiVi yakhe, then maybe I can like cancel her details. And I think I will also post my CV. I'll just cancel out my details. Okay. Someone says, Tandeka says, guys, we must try cruise ships nursing. And it pays well, and you get to travel the world. That is so nice. Our mom is here, Suzile, who is the public health specialist, and she's saying in the public health space, you need your NIMART APC as well as IMCI. And I'd like to believe, I'm not sure about APC, but IMCI, I saw it on Knowledge Hub, and it's for free. Someone says, I'm doing PG Deep in public health. Is doing a master's beneficial? It is. It is. Okay. Belegas is back. It is very important, Sanalwam, to do a master's in public health because the space is becoming competitive. So it's an advantage. I want to go up to the questions that were for whose corner? Z,
Hi.
there was a question here for you that was asking Ukuba, like, let me see. I think it was, what are the requirements for to get into SANBAS as a registered nurse?
It's 2 years experience in registered nurse only. If you are we want to be a donor care officer, it's like a professional nurse. We call it donor care officer. And for enrolled nurses, same thing, 2 years of experience and your enrolled nursing certificate.
But bafuna CV zethu.
No, I'll drop it tonight just before I
Yeah,
leave.
I'll block them out and then I will post them.
I have to check if I did put my last qualification. Ish, but I have to check if I updated it yet.
Okay, let's see bathini. Sifundiseni nge-employer letter. How do we apply with no study leave? Hey guys, let me tell you some things we can't say them online because we will be recorded and be taken to court. So we are very much scared to comment on certain things, but people have ways to go around these employer letter and all that. But I'm very scared, honestly, to say such things because there's a screen recorder, and then you send to the South African Nursing Council.
Oh, sana, when then your bread and butter is gone. Yo.
Guys, any questions for Umambele? Mr. Mav says, do what you must. Dala what you must, Mntase, to get to school. You just do what you must, guys. We all doing what we must to get where we want to get.
Hello, son. It's like
I want
that.
us to go back to that lady or gent who is in Namibia. Are they still here, Jay? Ati maybe like we don't want to answer them. Jay, are you still here? We need to dollar what we must. Dollar what you must, my darling. Yes, they are here. So on my side, Jay, firstly, I don't know if you probably would like to come and work in South Africa. And I'm not certain even what is your nursing curriculum looking like in Namibia. I'm very much aware that there is a lot of similarity between us as South African nurses as well as the Namibian nursing curriculum. Actually, it was similar before we changed ours. My advice for you, if you want to come to South Africa and build a concrete, solid like career for you this side, because obviously we know South Africa pays better, and you're gonna obviously come here legally, so people will not be mad and say you are coming to take their jobs. I would say rather do your bridging course. I don't know if you guys still have it. In South Africa, we don't have it anymore. If you guys have that 2 years bridging course, I would advise you to do it immediately in order for you to become a professional nurse. It doesn't matter if you have the bars or you don't have the bars. If you can do that qualification and then you become an enrolled nurse, and also you do the 1 year midwifery on your side, I don't know if you guys have it as 1 year midwifery. If you can do those, then you can come and build a career for yourself here in South Africa. The reason I'm saying this is because currently in South Africa, we are experiencing a challenge where our universities and our colleges do not have the capacity to take a lot of students. So if you come to South Africa and you say, Nurse Z, I'm going to come there and do my registered nurse program in South Africa, you will have to do it for 3 years. We no longer have the 2 year course. You'll have to do it for 3 years. You'll go to school and do a diploma for 3 years. And then once you are done, you'll have to do the 1 year midwifery. So I don't know. I believe that if you can do it in Namibia, it will be a little bit faster than you coming and doing it this side. Then once you can do those and then you come to South Africa, then you can specialize. You can do a specialty in South Africa. You will qualify to do a specialty in South Africa. For you to come to South Africa, you first need to speak to SAQA, which is the South African Qualification Association,
and then they convert your qualifications into the South African qualifications, then now you can speak to our council, which is the South African Nursing Council. And then the council will register you as a nurse in South Africa. Then you can start applying for jobs. I hope I make sense. That would be my advice for you. You will respond and tell me if you heard me, and tell me if you're hearing what I'm saying. Guys, do we have comments, questions for Upelekazi before Sivala? Sis Zuzile, do we have APC on Knowledge Hub? And NIMAT, I don't think we have NIMAT on Knowledge Hub. Unfortunately, NIMAT, you have to go and pay for it. Guys, comments, questions for Upele before we let her go? Sis Zuzile, we have NIMAT. Let me just bring in Sis Zuzile. We have NIMAT on Knowledge Hub. Or am I not hearing you? Am I hearing you well? We have NIMAT on Knowledge Hub. Can you please send me a request, Zuzile, because I always struggle to send you a request. Mampele, I thank you so much for your time. Question for her, why kunzima kanje ungena eSandbox?
Yeah, as I said, the problem is some of the most, okay, let me say most of the people is because their profiles on PNET, they're not sitting at 100%. They're sitting maybe at 80-something%, and they're sitting at 90-something%. And then when PNET is sort of taking some of the candidates, yours will be left behind because it's not full. Your profile is not full. So surely there's something that is not there. So it's only going to take those that has a full profile. And the other thing is, I'm not working at HR, but I know that it's some of the challenges that most of the people that are currently doing kunzima shem. It's really difficult. A lot of people have been saying they have been applying for years and they don't get a chance to sort of get an opportunity to go for an interview or something. And as I said, also the CV is very important.
I'm going to let you go now in case you've got things to do. And with your permission, I'm going to post your career conversation journey on YouTube as well, so that it may reference, you know, for those who couldn't join us today. People can always learn from you. I don't know ubandinga kubulela kanjani okanye how can I show you my heart, but my heart is, I don't know, like I feel now like Sana, I love you, and I have to see you in this.
No problem. Thank you so much for this platform. And yeah, 2 weeks back I was so sick. I wanted to do it, but I was like, hey, my voice was not voicing. So I'm so glad that we took this time today. And thank you also to the audience. Some of my babies actually just sent me a WhatsApp of screenshot of this conversation. She's currently doing another course at CPUT. She really wants to be a nurse. She stays 3 houses away from my home. She has always been saying, I inspire her. So I'm so glad, Pelokazi, that you are here on this live. And yeah, I'll respond to you soon.
Yeah. And also, we appreciate you, Ndombi. We love you. You are coming back for the financial literacy, Sanditi.
Yes, I'm coming back for Ezizimali. Bring your papers, bring your pens, bring your calculators. Bring your bank statements, go banzim.
Lila, and tissue. We must also bring tissue, Sana, because it's okay.
Bring tissues because I will be like guns everywhere, left, right, and center. You know, when we speak about money, it's not a very nice conversation because, yeah,
Guys, please also follow Mam Bele on TikTok. She does create content, and best believe you're going to be inspired. Good night, guest Tando Sam. I just want to see Suzile in the next 6 minutes that we are left with to just clarify what we have on Knowledge Hub. Evening, Mam Zu, and sorry for always pulling you. Yes, once I see you on the comments, you are on the mic.
Good evening, Z. Now ngizobaleka ne, I will run away. Good evening, Z, and everyone. So I just want to clarify the issue of the Nemart ne. Let me just before I talk about Nemart, there is APC on the Knowledge Hub. There are two APCs. There is a full course of APC, the updated one. There is also an updated APC. Remember, the guidelines have been updated. So for those that have not done APC before, that would like to register for the first time, they have to do the full course of the APC. And then for those that have done APC before, they just need to do them updated APC, because then now there are new cases that have been added on the new APC, the updated one. And then we have been struggling with IMCI for a long time because it was not on the Knowledge Hub, but now IMCI, it is on the Knowledge Hub. So we encourage that, can people register on the Knowledge Hub with the IMCI. So IMCI is available. And also the APC, two APCs. I want to specify the APCs. There are two APCs. One is the full course for those that have never done APC before. And then there is an updated one for those that have done APC before. And then I just want to talk about Nemart. I just want to say with Nemart, we still retain the course as Nemart because it was introduced as Nemart. But the course for Nemart, it was renamed 2018 to be Basic HIV for Professionals. So we just call it Nemart, but now it's called Basic HIV for Professionals. So we do have the course in the Knowledge Hub for all the professionals. So we do have the Basic HIV for Professionals, so they can be able to register. But for now, I think they were updating it because there are new guidelines. When I was checking on it, you were not able to enroll yourself. And remember, when the Knowledge Hub with the new courses, they just want to launch it. So it has not yet been launched. The moment it's being launched, I will update you guys that it's already been launched. So, but it is already there, but I think they are still working with some other things. But the same basic HIV for professionals that is there on the Knowledge Hub, it is the Nemart. And then, so the other thing that I just want to emphasize, when you do your basic HIV for professionals, for you to be recognized, it doesn't end up there with you doing the course. You get the certificate of attendance, but then you have to do the cases. You have to complete the POE. The POE, it consists them 24 cases of APC, and also it consists 30 cases of PEDS. That means all in all, you have to complete 54 cases for you to be certified. And then that's where now, when you are applying for these jobs on the corporate, we're gonna be asking you, are you Nemart certified? That means although you have attended the course of the Nemart, but post attending that Nemart, did you do your cases? So the cases, they are very, very important, because you will not learn anything with it. You will not learn everything by just doing that, because you need to do the practicals. So for the districts that are so lucky to have the mentors, they are the ones that are responsible for assisting with the completion of those cases. For some other districts, I know that they are using the nurses that are in the facilities that are experienced with the management of the HIV and TB patients to be the ones that are assisting with the completion of the POEs. So those are the critical things that for you to say, now I am fine, I have everything, do the NIMR and then be NIMR certified. And I just want to emphasize also something that there is no, I don't know, the life is paused, okay? There is no institution that gives a NEMART certification. It's only the regional training centers. So if you are in Gauteng, yes, if you are in Gauteng, it is the regional center for Gauteng that will be giving the certified certificate. If you are in Mpumalanga, it is the Mpumalanga RTC, which we call them RTCs, the regional training centers that are going to be giving the certificates. If any province where you are, it is the responsibility of the province. It's not the responsibility. Yes, the partners, if you are working in a district where the partners are supportive, it's only the partners, they have to send those POEs and be approved in the regional training center. So if it's the institution that is saying you have been certified, it's a no. It's in some of the corporates, they will not even take you for that. We need you to be having a certificate of certified certificate from the training regional centers, the RTCs. Thank you, Z. I hope it's clear to everyone.
Yes, Zuzile. I would like, you know, sometimes you always say, Zanele, go and do 1, 2, 3. I don't know, like, so for, let me say, I work in private, and obviously DOH is not going to certify, like, private people. Can't DOH also, like, give to private people so that people can be certified, Marasit Zuzi? Me, I don't know what doing what, but like isn't it limiting? Like, are they now not gatekeeping? Because I feel like they're gatekeeping certification.
It's not really that they are gatekeeping. We say, even if it's private, can they please contact the training regional centers, the RTCs? Yes, it's not that it's private. We are working with the privates where I am, we are working with them. If there is anything, we can give them the contact so that they know who are the relevant people that they contact. Ne? It's not the private institution, even themselves, if they are doing the trainings and they are doing the mentoring, can they please contact the regional training centers? And then they are going to be approving them and then being able to, because all the certificates, they must be signed in the regional training centers. Mm-hmm.
Personally, I don't know what will we ever be in this platform without you. Like, you know, the day you decided that when you no longer want to be on social media, me, I don't know what's going on. We will all perish here. But you've answered everyone, guys, and the people who are quoting different companies that are offering NIMART. Someone even asked, why is this company not being recognized by a certain organization? I think Sizuzila answered that. It's not that the company, they are not recognizing that NIMART, but they are saying you are incomplete. You are not certified. Is it certified?
Certified. Mm-hmm.
Certified. It's not that they are saying this NIMART program is fake, but they are saying you did not complete the whole thing. And obviously we are staying in various provinces, you guys. So you Google your own province, like your own district. It's called what, Kanene? RTC.
Yeah, it's RTC, is the regional training center. So in all the provinces, there are regional training centers in all the provinces, yes.
So you find your own in your district and communicate with them if you are working for private and say, hey, I would like to do NIMART and I wanted to know how do I go about doing the cases in the sub-district or in the district, and also how do I get mentorship. Thank you so much, Sis Zuzi, for always agreeing to us, bringing you in even when you didn't want to. We love you so much and you know that.
I love you too, guys.
Okay, guys, I think we are going to call it a night now.
I have the cases submitted. Where should I submit? Regional Training Center, once more. You need to contact you.
Is this person working?
Mpumikanene, which district are you in? I think that she's in Mpumalanga. I think Mpumi is in Mpumalanga, if I'm not mistaken. Or is it Limpopo? Mpumi? Sister Tabete? Uti Nkangala?
Nkangala, I think there is a partner. If I'm, I don't want to call the partners. There are partners. I don't want to call the partner's name. There is a partner that is working there with the province. Can she please find out from the partners? They are the ones that are going to be supporting her. There is a partner that is supporting Nkangala district, but I don't want to call the partner's name here.
And I think she works for a partner that side, if I'm not mistaken. Ngathi she recently left. Mpumemos, you were now working for a partner that side, right? I think it's going to be easy for her to find that information.
So can she please can she please inbox me?
Okay.
Yeah, I know my account. I've made it to be private. She can send a follow.
I'm sure with every live you will get 20 inboxes.
Yeah. Can she please send me an inbox, then I can direct her what to do.
Okay, sis.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, and thank you everyone. Have a good night, and if you joined us in the middle of the conversation, you're gonna find it on YouTube. Good night in Betuna. Have a blessed week. Bye. How do I pause now? How do